Scene one. Good afternoon. It's Wednesday the 6th of May, and on Monday the 4th of May I put up a video about a home recording device called the EKco Radiocorder, and many of you have written in and said you enjoyed it. Thank you very much for doing that. I'm sorry I don't answer all the comments, but I'm sorry I can't do that. But I do thank you very much, and in fact it was one comment that came in that triggered my alarm and dismay. This is a video of atonement. One of the people said, with the magnetic head, the moving iron pickup, which is also the recording head, did I change the rubber inside it? Thereupon hangs a tale. And just in case you're not familiar with them, we'll just have a quick look inside one of these pickups. This is a scrap head of the same type, and you'll just see it consists of a horseshoe magnet and two pole pieces that come to a point there, and then there in between is an armature. There's a needle and it's pivoted here, and it's got a suspension made of rubber. Now, I did replace that on Monday because obviously 90-year-old rubber has disintegrated. What I did not then go on to do is check the damping at the top of the armature. That was my fatal mistake. Here are the pole pieces seen from above, and you'll see that they're laminated. They're made out of layers of metal, like in a transformer, to stop magnetic eddy currents. They're also stepped so that when you get to this space here, which is the business area, so to speak, the magnetic field is concentrated there. And this fishtail, they call it, believe it or not, is of the armature, is that way round, in between in the concentrated magnetic field. And it does need some rubber there, some damping, otherwise the armature will have pronounced resonances, and also, of course, it can stick to one pole or other of the magnet. And the damping in the head that I'd got was completely petrified and disintegrated. Well, all right, I started off on the wrong foot and proceeded to continue to do so, because having replaced the suspension at the bottom, I thought it's all right now, and I tested it by trying to cut a record with it. But that was stupid, because it's a dual function thing. It will play a record and it will cut a record. But the best way to test it is to play an existing record with it and listen to what it sounds like. And if it sounds good, then the chances are it'll make a reasonable recording on a piece of aluminium. And I didn't, I just went ahead and I can't believe it, really. So anyway, let's see what let me show you what I've done to this head. Okay, here's the head, all ready to go, to be tested properly this time. We'll just take a close-up look at it. Okay, here we go. We've zoomed in. There are the pole pieces. There's the coil, of course, which was absent in the skeletal one. There's the armature, which has got bicycle valve rubber around it, the pivot, and then at the top, there's the top of the edge of the fishtail, and you can see I've taken another piece of bicycle valve rubber and slit it and super glued it to the top, to the fishtail. So the fishtail is now supported equally on both poles, and it can't click over to one, but it can vibrate, and the bicycle valve rubber is very soft. So now let's actually play it. Okay, we've fitted the proper arm, which is what we should have done in the first place, and we're going to play a 1936, I think it's 1936, Count Basie Decca. Oh, it's a Brunswick over here, of course. And the audio is going to go straight into the computer this time. You won't hear it through the speakers, the audio will go into the computer. Thank you.
it's a bit strident, but it's quite a solid sound. But there's one thing I did change, was that this is this Brunswick was just one that was lying around, a British Brunswick, and it's a World War II period. You can tell that because it's got a little T stamped in there, which is tax, purchase tax, which was put on records in 1941, I think. So it's a rather nasty, rough copy. And so I actually played this, which is a French, pre-war French Brunswick. It's the same record, it just sounds nicer. So to give the pickup every chance, which it deserves. So I think we can, say that we've got the thing on the run at the moment, and also, incidentally, the bar is open. So if you excuse me. Ah, that's better. Now, we can proceed and go back to, since the head will play, does it record? This is the moment of truth, and we're going to play this, what we've just cut, and it's going to go straight into the computer, and you shall be the judge of it. Woo-hoo! Say that persistence wins, and I'm grateful to my correspondent for making me go back and think again, and I think we've now done it properly. And I also apologise to the shade of EK Cole, founder of EKco, and they were in Southend-on-Sea. I've got a friend in Southend-on-Sea, and I shall send him this the link to the video. So, well, there we are. All's well that ends well. Here's to you. Keep safe in these very troublous, distressing times, and see you again soon. Bye.